on online FTP on structural assessment and repair and rehabilitation of structures. So last week we have the same topic, we are continuing here. So corrosion experts of repair and rehabilitation of structures. So last week we a little bit internet and other issues should be there. Again, I recall that last week what we thought that couple of minutes. So the corrosion, so how the corrosion will be happen. So what are the reagents? So the, what are the chemical reactions in corrosion, one cathodic and anodic reactions. So what are the induce the parameters for corrosions, whether the temperature or environmental aspects or reaction take place between the components. So all will be discussed in the last session, as well as for that how the protective coatings and other technology nowadays is viable to take the prevention of the corrosion. It's also seen that. So same like that for techniques available. So how the corrosion take taken place in the real world, problems and issues. They taken for what are the technology. Nowadays they were somewhat in IoT, Internet of Things materials also available. Just to put on your instrument, just chipping the wall or concrete, you put your instrument, so directly you know that what is the corrosion rate and other relevant data. Now even the plotting the graphs is also available nowadays, a lot of modern technologies available. So apart from I go through the case study, based on the case study we are using that one part of the corrosion experiment RCPT in rubberized concrete. So in the case study we discuss about this is one of the sponsor project for us, IRMRA, Indian Rubber Manufacturing Association in Thane, Mumbai. They give the funding agency for giving us for doing the project, the waste tire material, how will build how the engas to waste management that will be using for concrete aspects. So that experiment we will be discuss about the mortars as well as for concrete rubberized concrete mortars and as well as rubberized cubes, paver block. This we compare with all strengths, compressive strength and spread tensile strength and other tensile strength and other tests we have conducted. Based on the test we have evaluated RCPT, the RCPT results also discussed in the last session. And now very immense pleasure to deliver that another case study. It is directly related to the corrosion aspects of the concrete. So wherever that more coincided our FTP topic, it is done by our one of our scholar. It is for the study on geopolymer coating for evaluation of corrosion protection of steel reinforcement and RCC structures. So the we are objective the study the behavior of the geopolymer coating in the steel reinforcement to study about the bonding properties between the coated reinforcement and the concrete, to evaluate the durability of geopolymer coating, to reduce the environmental pollutions. So of course we again tell about the corrosion. It is a destruction of the metal or an alloy because of a chemical or electrochemical reactions with the surrounding environment or medium. Don't think that is only concrete or other times is called as steel reinforcement. So other material also they usually corrode in nature. Say I saw one of research going on for in mine waste. The mine waste will be that engas the solid waste management with corrosion impedance and other related research also going on somewhere else in world. So the thing of environment will be required will be more, not for particular in concrete, particular in steel, even other metals. So we saw in last week also we were brass plate with top will be an iron plate, same like that an aluminium and iron plate. So they both will be composite material, combined material, the joint, the corrosion rate will be varied based on the rate. The concrete will be or the metal will be which one will lead to early corrosion or take late corrosion. So it is a metallurgy in a reverse process for here mine, waste, iron ore. So steel is very easily corroded. You know that Fe2+ is easily converted Fe3 or iron oxide. So that type of corrosions will be take place, compare with the steel, the aluminum will be as easily corrode. Same like that for in magnesium as well as sodium is corrode easy. In compare with other way of corrosion scale, the diamond and as well as this one silver and gold, you see corroding will be very less. So the mine waste here, the iron ore, so the steel mill reducing the refilling of the casting of the material. So what to reply of that? Roller and as well as the pipe, so the lot of sheets as well as reinforcement will be provided. We in the building industry or construction industry, the reinforcement is steel will be major contributing to other material or other metals. So already you saw that acceleration of corrosion, the physical characteristics is exposed to area is lesser, cover increased corrosion rate, time of exposure, environmental characteristics. So what will be that in acidic in nature, or normally the more corrode in acidic nature, the pH 5 to 6, 6.5, there are more corrosion should be take place. In sulfur gas environment for an acid rain, so temperature, moisture. So this is an environment of physical environment. Of course, we see that for in Taj Mahal, where a lot of studies are going, environmental experts. In Yamuna River, the bank of Yamuna River, the Agra, lot of tannery industries will be there, lot of leather industries will be there. They creating that pollution to an environment, air, they may be forming the acid rain and other natural calamities. The whatever in the olden days they using for in lime and other material, they easily have a corroding nature. So the other way of you see here, for example, of reinforcement corrosions. So they are banned. So we are for in bridge, there are the corroded here also the for proper cover and proper compaction of concrete. It is possible also the corroding the material. The losses due to corrosion. So waste material and energy, economic losses. So somewhat viable direct and indirect losses. Sometimes that entire structure will collapse. So indirect losses, shutdown, loss of product, loss of efficiency, product of contamination, over design. So same like that, no impact on the health. So now the other thing called is monitorings, health monitoring of structures. So it's also one of the booming topic nowadays for most of research which is carried out. Same like that for forensic engineering. So it's also one of topic, same like that in for an IoT. Internet of Things. So wherever you fix that small chips and equipment, they may be monitored in the lab.